So welcome back folks, this is Shardul Yavande from Mace College, and in this video we'll talk about flow control mechanisms which are there on data link layer in computer networks. So what is flow control mechanism? So why do we need a flow control mechanism? So let's say if a sender is sending a file to a receiver, okay, and sender sends a file at 100 Mbps of speed, but at the receiving end, the receiver downloads or simply gets the file at 1 Mbps of speed. Well, the speed, there is a difference in speed, right? So at the receiving end, there may have a traffic congestion of the packets. Here the packet in networking we call data as packets. So there may occur a traffic congestion at the receiving side as the receiving speed is low as compared to at the sender speed. So receiving speed is 1 Mbps. So obviously the packets may be lost or they may occur or they may cause a traffic congestion. So for that reason we need to have something called as flow control mechanisms. So in computer networks and data link layer, we have various flow control mechanisms. The most important, the most big flow control mechanisms, which will happen over here now. So the first one is we have sliding window. First one is sliding window protocol. Okay, the second one we have is go back and protocol, and the third one we have is selective repeat protocol. Okay, so there are many protocols, but most three important protocols which we have is sliding window protocol, go back and protocol, and selective repeat protocol. So we'll see each of them in detail how they work and how they can control the flow of data from the sender to the receiver side so that the packets are not lost and there is no traffic congestion at the receiving end. So the very first one we'll have a look at sliding window protocol. So let's have a look at sliding window protocol. So before starting with the sliding window protocol, let us first understand what is a window size. So this is the most important term, window size. So window size, that means size of the window. So we have window in our house, okay. So here in networking, we have window size same as, let's say this is our window, okay. The size of the window, let's say if it is 3, that means we can send only 3 packets. Okay, if the size of the window is 4, that means 4 packets will be sent in this window, not more than that. So size of the window or simply a window size basically says how much amount of data will be transmitted from the sender to the receiver end. Okay, so size of window may differ at of sender as well as of receiver. Let's say we can have a window size at sender as 4 and at receiver the window size may be 1. So how this flow control mechanisms need to take place, we will have a look with the help of sliding window protocol. So let's say we have a sender. So this is our sender and this is our receiver. Okay, sender and receiver. So let's say sender's window size is 4. That means sender will send 4 packets at a time and receiver's window size is 1. That means at a time receiver only accept 1 data at a time, right? So window size is 4. So let's send our packets. This is 0, 1, 2, 3. So 4 packets, okay, starting with 0, 1, 2, 3. You can take the number 1, 2, 3, but let's take 0. So this is my data which is being transmitted from sender to the receiver, right? But at the receiving side, it will decode only 1 as window size is 1. So it will receive only 1 packet at a time. So this sender needs to wait for the acknowledgement from receiver. So always remember, whenever transmission takes place from sender to receiver, it always happens with acknowledgement. Whenever receiver send acknowledgement for this packet, then only the sender can send the next packet. But as of now, as window size is 4, so at the time, sender would say send 4 packets to the receiver. So as this acknowledgement for this particular 0 comes, sender will send the next packet, which is 4. So let's say our window size, the window size is 4. So 0, 1, 2, 3. So this is our window size. This is our window size with value 4. Okay, so 4 packets. So when receiver sends an acknowledgement for this particular packet, which is 0, sender will send the next packet, which is 4. So that means, as name says, sliding window protocol. So that means it will slide to its left side, and this we get, which is 4. Because for acknowledgement 0, it will, when we get an acknowledgement for 0, the window will slide to the next part and next packet will be sent. Similarly, when receiver will send acknowledgement for 1, okay, acknowledgement for 1, then it will send the next packet, which is 5, and then so on. Okay, so this is basically sliding window protocol, how it works. So in the next protocol, we'll see in the next video. Thank you.